Some days you wake up and the sun is shining and the birds are singing and you get an email from a Muslim who agrees with you that the YouTube Trust and Safety Team is absolute garbage. Christians, Muslims, atheists, Hindus, we have our disagreements, but the fundamental dividing line in the world today is not between Christians and Muslims or between theists and atheists. The fundamental dividing line in the world today is between people who are obsessed with controlling you and people who aren't obsessed with controlling you. There are plenty of jihadis who are obsessed with controlling you. There are leftists who are obsessed with controlling you. But as long as you're still allowed to communicate with the rest of the world, you can expose and refute the jihadis and the leftists who want to control you. The terrifying thing about the trust and safety teams of YouTube and Facebook and Twitter is that they're trying to create a world where you can't expose and refute the people who are trying to control you. And that's why I've come to view the radicalized, extremist trust and safety teams of the major social media platforms as the world's greatest enemies of freedom. Let's check out this message from a Muslim who's starting to recognize the problem. Hello, David Wood. My name is, I'll leave that out, and I am a Muslim and watch some of your videos sometimes because I find them to be interesting. I like to see opinions from all sides. And yet, there are people who only want you to see one opinion from one side. I saw your videos on YouTube's hate speech policies, and I can't agree with you more. It is a danger to freedom of speech because what is hate speech to them is subjective, and they can take down anything they disagree with in the name of hate speech. I've had my channel for years now, and I did not post any videos, but I did comment a lot, and sometimes I would engage in debates in the comment sections, and I did say other things that I do regret, but I'm only a human that makes mistakes. YouTube terminated my channel without any warnings or strikes and rejected my appeal because they said that I said hate speech. Now I see exactly what you mean when you tell your audience that these companies are the biggest threat to freedom of speech. And although I disagree with some of the things you say, I believe that you, like anyone else, should have the right to have freedom of speech. I don't know if you have the ability to help me get my channel back, but I assume you do because you have a lot of experience on YouTube. So I ask you, out of the kindness of your heart, to help me, because I know that a person who follows Jesus is a person that will help others. Thank you. Well, my Muslim friend, sadly, I have no connections at YouTube, and I can tell you that their appeals process, once they've accused you of hate speech, is a complete joke. When one of these safe spacers on the trust and safety team has his or her or zer or whatever feelings hurt by something you said in a comment, nothing you can possibly say will change his or her or zer mind. Now, in theory, you shouldn't have been banned because according to the YouTube Trust and Safety Team, you're a member of a protected group. Maybe they didn't realize that you're a Muslim. Ali Dawah is allowed to literally call for the public beheadings of millions of people, and the YouTube Trust and Safety Team defends him because he's a member of a protected group. Whatever you said that they labeled hate speech, it couldn't have been worse than Ali Dawah calling for the public beheadings of millions of ex-Muslims. So, maybe you didn't clearly identify yourself as a Muslim. The other problem you have is that you're not a popular YouTuber. YouTube has been banning small channels left and right, to the point where some days I'm losing subscribers because so many channels of my subscribers are being banned. YouTube really doesn't seem to care about banning small channels because the small channels aren't making Google any money, and the small channels usually can't make a big fuss about getting banned. I'm not a huge channel, but I'm big enough to make money for YouTube through channel memberships and super chats and such, and I'm big enough to raise a bit of a ruckus when they finally ban me. YouTube is being very, very smart here. They're banning the small channels first, taking away subscribers so that By the time they start banning the bigger channels, it'll be even harder for the bigger channels to complain. In the meantime, they're hoping that the bigger channels heed all of their warnings and learn to submit. At the end of the day, they don't want content creators leaving the platform. That's just bad for business. They don't want to kick us off. They want to control us. But if they can't control us, they will kick us off. So, make no mistake about it, my Muslim friend, I will be banned just as surely as you've been banned. Anyone who's saying anything remotely controversial on this platform will either submit to the ever-changing ideals of the trust and safety team or be canceled. There is no scenario where I'm going to submit to these morons, so you and I will eventually be on another platform. If I were you, I would try out some of the alternative platforms and see which one you like best. Alternative platforms like Rumble and BitChute are growing rapidly, primarily because YouTube is banning people who like to think for themselves. Hope that helps. Let me know where you end up.